Let us start the class. Multiplexing. Here, multiplexing is technique is to combine and send the multiple data streams over a single medium. Here, multiplexing is a technique that is used to combine and send the multiple data streams over a single medium. So the process of combining data streams is called multiplexing. The process of combining multiple data streams is called multiplexing. Here, multiplexing is achieved by the device called multiplexer. Here, multiplexing is achieved by using a device called multiplexer. So this multiplexer combines n input lines to generate single output line. Here, multiplexer combines n input lines to generate single output line. That is the definition of multiplexing and multiplexer. So here, multiplexing follows many to one. That means many inputs, that is n inputs, one output. So multiplexing follows many to one, that means many input lines, one output line. And on the other hand, demultiplexing operates signal into its component signals. That means one to many. Here, demultiplexing means one to many. That is one input line, many output line. That is demultiplexing. So here, demultiplexing receives data from single medium and identifies each one and send to different receivers. So multiplexing many to one, that means many input line, one output line. On the other hand, demultiplexing, here one to many, one input line and many output lines. So your demultiplexing receives data from single medium and identifies each one and send to different receivers. That is demultiplexing. Now we discuss different types of multiplexing: frequency division multiplexing, second one time division multiplexing, and third one code division multiplexing. Your first one, frequency division multiplexing. So frequency division multiplexing, when your carrier is frequency, we use this FDM, frequency division multiplexing. When the carrier is frequency, the FDM is used. Frequency division multiplex is used. And this FDM divides the spectrum in the logical channels and allocates one user to each channel. Here, each user can use the channel frequency independently and has exclusive access of it. So in the frequency division multiplexing, the channel is dedicated to user based on frequency. In frequency division multiplexing, the channel is dedicated to one user based on frequencies. And it sends signals in several different frequency ranges and carries multiple video channels on a single cable. Here in frequency division multiplexing, the channel is dedicated to user based on frequency. See here. User one, channel one, and frequency one, and user two, channel two, frequency two, and user three, channel three, frequency three. So here three users. User one, send the data over the frequency range of F1 through the channel one. Next, user two, send the data through the channel two over the frequency range of F2. Next, user three, send the data through the channel three over a frequency range of F3. Okay, now these three channels, channel one and channel two and channel three, are combined into the single channel. Okay, N to one, many to one, many input lines, one output line. That is your multiplexer. Okay, here F1, F2, F3, channel one and channel two and channel three. So these three channels are combined into the single channel by using your multiplexer. Okay, and next here, we allocate one frequency for each user on the same channel. Here, this channel is allocated to three users. Only single channel is allocated to three users. Suppose user one, allocate your channel within the frequency range of F1. Next, user two, we allocate a channel within the frequency range of F2. Next, user three, we allocate a channel for frequency range of F3. See here, one channel is dedicated to multiple users based on frequency. That is frequency division multiplexing. Next, demultiplexer. So here demultiplexer means one to many. Here one channel is converted to the multiple channels. Here single channel is converted to multiple channels. Channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. So this is about frequency division multiplexing. So here one channel is dedicated to multiple users based on frequency. See here, channel 1 and channel 2 and channel 3 are converted to the single channel by using multiplexer. Many channels are converted to single channel. Many to one, that is multiplexing. And this one channel is allocated to the different users based on frequency. Suppose during the frequency range F1, the channel is dedicated to user 1. During the frequency range F2, the channel is dedicated to user 2. During the frequency range F3, the channel is dedicated to the user 3. Next one, time division multiplex. Next one, time division multiplexing. So here, in the time division multiplexing, one channel is dedicated to users only for short period of time. Your channel is dedicated to users only for short period of time within the some time interval. See here, A, B, C, D. Okay, four systems or four users, A, B, C, D, and four channels. So A send the data in channel 1, B send the data in channel 2, C send the data through the channel 3, and D send the data through the channel 4. So four systems and four different channels. Now we convert all these four channels into the single channel. Okay, multiple channels to single channel by using multiplexer. Okay, and next, this single channel is dedicated to users only for short period of time in round robin manner. Suppose this system having four input systems A, B, C, D. Okay, and each of the data stream is divided into units which are allocated time slots in the round robin manner. Here we allocate this channel in the round robin manner. Okay, this single channel is allocated to users only for short period of time in round robin manner. See here, first we allocate the time slot 1 to the A, next B, next C, next D. Next, once again round robin means once again A, B, C, D, and next A, B, C, D. Okay, on the other hand, demultiplexer divides this single channel into the multiple channels. So this is time division multiplexing. In time division multiplexing, one channel is dedicated to multiple users only for short period of time in round robin manner. See, a time slot 1 is allocated to A, 2 is allocated to B, 3 is allocated to C, and 4 is allocated to D, and next round robin, once again we start from A, B, C, D, and so on. Okay, so this is also called as synchronous time division multiplexing. This is also called as synchronous time division multiplexing. And there is another type of time division multiplexing, that is statistical time division multiplexing. There is another type of time division multiplexing, that is statistical time division multiplexing. So in statistical time division multiplexing, the time slots are dynamically allocated slots according to demand. The time slots are dynamically allocated according to their demand. Okay, that means here the multiplexer checks each stream in a round robin manner and allocates a slot to input line only if there is a data is present or not. Otherwise it skips to the next stream. Suppose first we allocate the time slot to A, next we allocate the time slot to B, next year C, the input system C does not contain any data. Here the input system C does not contain any data. Then in the case of statistical time division multiplexing, we did not allocate any slot to that C. Okay, if there is no data, we are not allocating any slot to the data. Suppose A contains data, so we allocate time slot to A. Next, B contains data, we allocate time slot to B. Next, C does not contain any data means we did not allocate any time slot to that C. Skip that C and next allocate time slot 3 to D. Okay, this is in the case of statistical time division multiplexing. Or if you use synchronous time division multiplexing, if C does not contain data, and we also give the time slot to data. Okay, even there is no data in the C, then also we allocate time slot to C. Okay, that is time division multiplexing, synchronous time division multiplexing. So the difference between synchronous time division multiplexing and statistical time division multiplexing is, remember the point, A contains the data, B contains the data, and C does not contains the data. If C does not contains the data, then in the case of synchronous time division multiplexing, here we allocate time slot to C. In case of statistical time division multiplexing, we did not allocate any time slot to the C. Okay, we are not allocating any time slot to C. Just skip that input stream C and go to next D. That is time. So this is about time division multiplexing. And next one, code division multiplexing, CDM. So your code division multiplexing is a multiplexing technique that uses spread spectrum communication. In spread spectrum communication, a narrow band signal is spread over larger band of frequency or across multiple channels via division. So your CDM, that is code division multiplexing, is used to allow multiple signals from multiple users to share a common communication channel, that is called CDMA, code division multiple access. Here CDM, code division multiplexing, is used to allow multiple signals from multiple users to share a single channel. And this technology is called code division multiplexing. So in code division multiplexing, we use a technology that is code division multiple access, CDMA. So in CDMA, each group of users is given a one code, shared code, and individual conversations are encoded in a digital sequence. So this is about code division multiplexing. So in code division multiplexing, we use a one technology called CDMA. So this technology, in this technology, each group of users is given a one shared code, and individual communications are encoded in a digital sequence. And the data is available on shared channel, but not only those users associated with particular code can access the data. Here the data is available on the one communication channel, but only those users associated with particular code can access the data. So this is about CDMA, code division multiple access. So these are the different types of multiplexing: frequency division multiplexing, time division multiplexing, and last one, CDM, code division multiplexing. So first one, frequency division multiplexing. Here channel is dedicated to users only for frequency, particular frequency. And next, time division multiplexing. Here one channel is dedicated to users only for short period of time, particular time interval. And next, CDM, code division multiplexing. Here we use a technology called CDMA, code division multiple access. So here each group of users given a one shared code, only those users associated with this shared code can access the data. Next one, digital modulation techniques. Next topic, digital modulation techniques are used to convert digital signals to the analog signals. Digital modulation techniques are used to convert digital signals to analog signals. So there are three types of digital modulation techniques: amplitude shift keying, ASK; second one, frequency shift keying, FSK; third one, phase shift keying, PSK. Now we discuss each modulation technique. These modulation techniques are used to convert digital signals to analog signals. So first one here, amplitude shift keying. Amplitude shift keying. So here Amplitude shift keying is a type of amplitude modulation which represents the binary data in the form of variations in the amplitude of a signal. Here, amplitude shift keying is a type of amplitude modulation which represents binary data in the form of variations in the amplitude of a signal. So any modulation signal has a high frequency carrier. So the binary signal when ASK modulated gives zero value for low input and it gives carrier output for high input. So here the binary signal when ASK modulated gives a zero value for low input and carrier output for high input. See here, first one input binary sequence. See here, input is zero, low input. And here ASK modulated output wave is here, low, okay, zero value. So zero value for low input. And here there is a waveform that is carrier output. So carrier output for high input, that is here one. So when the input is zero, here the output is zero. Okay, when the input is low, it gives a zero value. When the input is high, that means here one, high input. When the input is high, it gives carrier output, means there is a waveform. So whenever the input is zero, here this one also zero, output also zero. Whenever the input is high, there is a carrier output, that means there is a waveform. Okay, that is amplitude shift keying. So in amplitude shift keying, the binary signal when ASK modulated gives a zero value for low input and gives the carrier output for high input. That means if the input is low, that is if the input is zero, then the output waveform is zero. Next, if the input is high, then there is a carrier output. That means then there is a waveform. See here, input binary sequence. So if it is zero here, so this one also zero. Next, if it is one, that is high input, here there is a waveform. That means carrier output. Next, zero, zero. Next, here one. So there is a waveform, that is carrier output. Next, zero, zero. Next, one. So there is a waveform here. Next, zero, zero. Next, one. Here, waveform. That is amplitude shift keying. Next one, frequency shift keying. Next one is frequency shift keying. So this is a digital modulation technique in which frequency of the carrier signal varies according to digital signal changes. Here, frequency shift keying is the digital modulation technique in which frequency of the carrier signal varies according to digital signal changes. So the output of FSK modulated wave is high in frequency for binary high input and low in frequency for binary low input. So the output of FSK modulated output wave is high in frequency for binary high input and low in frequency for binary low input. See here we use two frequencies, F1 and F2. Okay, here we use two frequencies, F1 and F2. Here F1 represent binary 0 and F2 represent binary 1. Here F1 represent binary 0 and F2 is the frequency that represent binary 1. So here binary 1s and 0s are called mark and space frequencies. Here the binary 1s and 0s are called mark and space frequencies. So F1 is the frequency that represent binary 0 and F2 is the frequency that represent binary 1. If it is one here, see here two frequencies F1 and F2. So here if you observe F1, the waveforms are wider. Okay, here waveforms are wider. And if you observe F2, the waveforms are closer. Here, if you observe F1 and F2, here F1 waveforms are wider and here F2 the waveforms are closer. See here, first one 1. So here waveforms are closer, here F2. Next here 0. So waveforms are wider, here F1. Next F2. Okay, here. Next FG, F1. Next F2, F1. Next F2. Okay. So here F1 is the frequency that represent binary 0, and F2 is the frequency that represent binary 1. See here, if the 0 input means we represent the waveform F1. If the 1 input, we represent the waveform F2. That is frequency shift keying. Next one, phase shift keying. So here, phase shift keying is a digital modulation technique in which the phase of the carrier signal is changed by the varying the sine and cosine inputs at a particular time. So here, in the phase shift keying, we are changing the phase to 180 degrees. Here we're changing the phase. And amplitude and frequency remains constant. So in the phase shift keying, we are changing the phase. The phase of the carrier signal is changed by varying the sine and cosine inputs at a particular time. See here, this one is the input sequence. Here 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay, and this one is the binary phase shift keying modulated output wave. See here, waveforms are changed. Okay. So in the previous frequency shift keying here, in some point here, these waveforms are closer. And in the phase shift keying, we are changing the phase. Here waveforms are little bit wider, okay? So these are the three digital modulation technique used to convert digital signals to the analog signals. Amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying, and phase shift keying. In next class, we discuss transmission media. Different types of transmission media, guided transmission media, and unguided transmission media.